The Foreign Office, November the 2nd, 1917. Dear Lord Rothschild, I have much pleasure in conveying to you, on behalf of His Majesty's Government, the following declaration of sympathy with Jewish Zionist aspirations, which has been submitted to and approved by the Cabinet.
So it's possibly the most famous letter in modern Jewish history, and it begins with three words. Dear Lord Rothschild. Why was it that this letter was sent by the Foreign Secretary to your great uncle Walter?
It's an interesting question because he was really interested in ornithology, although he became interested in Zionism. I think the reason was this, that it was primarily a movement from Eastern Europe, but they didn't clarify who was in charge of that movement. And in addition, it was, after all, in Great Britain. So they felt that the Rothschild family should be the one to whom it was addressed. And Walter was Lord Rothschild, and he was a Zionist. And those really are the background reasons.
So Walter received the Balfour Declaration, and I have a copy here. And I wonder if I could possibly ask you to read it for us.
Yes, indeed. Yeah. I'm going to put on my spectacles to make sure I read it accurately. His Majesty's Government view with favour the establishment of Palestine as a national home for the Jewish people and will use their best endeavours to facilitate the achievement of this object, it being clearly understood that nothing shall be done which may prejudice the civil and religious rights of existing non-Jewish communities in Palestine or the rights and political status enjoyed by Jews in any other country. I should be grateful if you would bring this declaration to the knowledge of the Zionist Federation. Yours, Arthur Balfour.
And here it is, the Balfour Declaration. What do you feel when you see it here?
I genuinely feel it's one of the most extraordinary moments in the history of the Jewish people. If you think it took 3,000 years to get to this. And then you say, how did this miracle happen? And it's the most incredible piece of opportunism. I mean, if you think you had an impoverished would-be scientist, Heim Weizmann, who somehow gets to England, meets a few people, including members of my family, seduces them. He has such great charm and conviction. He gets to Balfour, and he unbelievably persuades Balfour and Lloyd George, the Prime Minister, and most of the ministers, that this idea of the national home for Jews should be allowed to take place. I mean, it's so, so unlikely. Then he's, you know, starts to fight a difficult battle with the British cabinet, and this letter goes through five drafts, as you know. And in the end, it comes out as a rather compromising letter. I mean, the essential point is there for the Jewish community to fasten on to. You have the first bit, which promises a national home rather than the national home, and then you have the bit that nothing that's to be done should in any way harm the Arab community. But you come back to the big point, which is that this is perhaps the greatest event in Jewish life for thousands of years, and it's a miracle that it took place.